Thank you. It is a great pleasure to be here. We've seen a little bit of carbon already. And because life has appeared on Earth more than 3 billion years ago, most of the non-organic carbon, at least at the subsurface, is thought to be biologic. Whether they derived from biological activities, present-day activity, or from past fossil biological activity. In this latter case, carbon can be stored and eventually recycling in rock reservoir through time. Organic molecules is of wide interest in our society, for example, to make plastics, to fuel cars, or to make other organic compounds of interest within chemical lab. In nature, very small organic compounds have been recognized as abiotic. The most abundant one is methane, and it can be accompanied by some other small simple molecules such as short alkane or organic acid. And identifying if there's other abiotic compounds on Earth is one of the main goals of the DCO. We know that these three molecules appear all together at the bottom of the ocean along the mid-Atlantic ridge, where they escape from this tall carbonate chimney. This is the example of the Lost City hydrothermal field. Because of those observations and of some other characteristics of this site, such a hydrothermal environment has been proposed as one of the most propitious ones for life emergence on Earth. However, without evidences for more complex organic compounds abiotically formed, it has been also proposed that life's ingredient was brought to the Earth by meteorite and that it has an extraterrestrial origin. Indeed, some meteorite contains a wide variety of organic compounds, ranging from very small, simple ones to large, complex ones, including amino acids, for example. But is it really the only option? During this last year, we've worked collectively to show that actually there may be another option. It was again at the bottom of the ocean, but not at hydrothermal vent, but below them, within the rock section, the rock substrate. A rock section of 2 kilometers depth has been drilled during an IODP oceanographic cruise several years ago. The rock core, as you can see on the right, has been cut in very thin slices in order to identify its composition. We identified first a series of minerals, and then by coupling high-resolution methods of characterization and imagery, it was possible to highlight the abiotic formation of an amino acid within the clay, so helped by the minerals themselves. You can see them located in the green area on the picture. But then, that was not the only compound we found. Going deeper in the rock section, we also identified additionally abiotic organic compounds trapped this time within mineral microcavities like the one circled in red. These cavities, called fluid inclusion, are very abundant in this kind of rock section. High-resolution imagery highlights the fact that these molecules are more complex. They can be stick on the wall cavity or mixed with the mineral inside the cavity. The picture should have been colored, but I don't know why. You should have seen that on the right, close to the red arrow. Within the cavities, these more complex abiotic compounds are associated with sulfur and nitrogen-bearing gases, hence providing a series of very interesting precursors for building new paths toward life emergence within hydrothermal environments. Overall, these results highlight the fact that on Earth, abiotic organic compounds can be much more various and complex than expected, and that rocks play a key role in their formation and preservation. We are just at the beginning of the exploration of these unappreciated forms of carbon on Earth, and efforts have to be maintained to better understand their variety, their occurrence condition, and their formation mode in different geological contexts. It is essential to better address their impact on life, today and in the past, and also on the global carbon cycle. Finally, it's necessary to better understand them, to better interpret the organic signal detected on other planetary bodies, like Mars, where organic molecules are detected and where traces of life are actively seek. Thank you.